Hi everyone. In this tutorial, we will create an animated slider with ripple effects using Swiper and GSAP. This slider features smooth transitions and animated images with a circular mask. Let's get started. Let's look at the HTML structure. We add the CDN links for Swiper and GSAP. By the way, I've included the page links in the description. You can access them easily. We create a Swiper slider with multiple slides. We use navigation buttons to move between slides. Each slide includes a title and three image layers. Three identical images are placed on a single slide to create the ripple effect. Now let's move on to the Swiper.js functionality. The slider uses a fade effect for smooth transitions between slides. We also enable navigation using the next and previous buttons. After styling, we will animate the layers using GSAP. Here we will add text animation, a circular mask, and media queries. This font will be used for the title. We add this background color to smoothen the slide transitions. Each slide is designed to cover the entire screen using CSS grid. The title is centered on the slide. It will appear with an animation. It smoothly moves to its original position when the slide becomes active. Each slide has three image layers stacked on top of each other. They are initially hidden and smoothly fade in when the slide becomes active. We add a semi-transparent black overlay. The mask image is applied to reveal specific parts of an element. We adjust the size of the middle and inner classes. The background color of the middle layer changes based on the data color attribute. The next and previous buttons have a rounded background to improve visibility. Finally, we add media queries to make the slider responsive across different screen sizes. The mask sizes and button padding are adjusted based on the screen width. Let's add animations to the layers using GSAP. We select the images inside the layer and middle classes. This animation scales up the images in the active slide with a staggered effect. It starts from the end, which is the inner mask. This animation makes the image of the middle class fade in smoothly. We ensure the animation appears for the first slide when the page loads. We need to reset all previous animations before transitioning to the newly active slide. We use Kill Tweens Off to stop any ongoing animations. Then, we reset the scale to its default value to ensure a clean animation start. This event triggers the animations when the slide changes. We select the swiper navigation buttons to control user interactions. We disable the buttons to prevent slide transitions before the animation ends. Then the buttons are re-enabled after 1.5 seconds. The event listeners prevent immediate navigation. Then they call the Disable Buttons function and trigger the animations with a delay. And there you have it. We've built the animated slider with ripple effects, smooth fade transitions, and a circular mask. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the bell icon so you never miss out on the latest tutorials. Thanks for watching.